Okay, now in this scenario, we're gonna be talking about snake bites. We had a gentleman who was working in his yard. A ball gets thrown into an area that he wasn't working. As he reached down for the ball, he doesn't see the snake in the grass and it strikes out of the defense. He gets struck on the hand. And the biggest point we want to cover here is not only scene safety. Number one, if we killed the snake, we should probably be bringing that snake with this victim to the hospital so they can identify the venom to know what kind of anti-venom to give this person, if you can. Don't get struck in the meantime, though, trying to get the snake. Number two, if you have a snake bite kit and you know how to use it, by all means, use it. But number three, let's say that we do not have a snake bite kit. Let's say that all we have is a pressure bandage. The first thing that we're gonna do is activate emergency medical services by calling 911. Once 911 is on the way, we wanna get this patient into a sitting position so that when they get dizzy, or if they get dizzy, they don't fall down. Now the next thing we wanna do is we're going to actually start to bandage this with a pressure bandage. This is an ACE wrap. And I just want to start wrapping around the affected limb as high up the limb as I can. What this is doing when I wrap this tight enough that it compresses the tissue, but not so tight that it works like a tourniquet, is that it helps to retard the absorption of the venom that has been injected into their body. Now, all while I'm doing this, of course, I'm trying to reassure the person that they're in good hands, that emergency medical services is on the way, and that we're gonna take good care of them. What I don't wanna have happen is them get excited, jump up, walk around, anything to increase their heart rate, and then actually start to circulate that venom even more. What I don't wanna do is use a cold pack. That has been suggested in other guidelines. That's been ruled out. And I don't want to actually suck the venom out. That's kind of an old fashioned, you know, kind of a saying as well. We're not doing that anymore. So what we're really doing is we're actually just going to bandage. We're going to keep it wrapped tight. And we're going to keep the limb lower than their heart to help, again, assist us in keeping the venom at the snake bite area down next to their leg, and then make sure that we get them to the ambulance without moving them any more than we have to. In other words, I'm not going to walk them across the park, or I'm not going to walk them across the road. Ideally, we'll bring the stretcher to them, or we'll pick them up in a golf cart, or we'll be able to actually transport them so that they can stay as still as possible. Get them to the hospital that has the anti-venom. That's something that's going to be good to tell 911 so that we make sure we bring them to the right location so that they can get the treatment as soon as possible and get this person turned around and save their life.